sounds good. How's the oil pressure look on that one? Better. Turn your phone off, you guys, Steve.
I wonder if that knurling is just maybe too aggressive.
Steve,
Steve,
the heart
like your style.
You'll take that cap one? Yep.
That baby. All right, here we go. Pull number three. We got her strapped down real tight.
Got to rip the car in half with the strap.
On Steve.
Thank you.
time. We made a pull before that, and it spun again. We put that spray piece on it, and I think it turned it up a little bit.
You had to get higher up now.
Yeah. Oh my god. 1600 wheels, that's insane. Dude, did you see it separate?
Yes, I saw the suspension was like just trying as hard as to get away.
In the sidewall was insane.
Get away from this thing.
It's trying to rip off the dyno portion.
Sixteen hundred and nine horsepower on that one. 19 pounds of boost. It's gonna make some adjustments and rip it again.
That is 1839 right there. 1909 on the standard correction. So, anyways.
All pretty, oops, sorry. All pretty happy there.
I think I'll let it sit for a second, and I think I'll turn it up more and check the data log.
Live action begins.
Live action.
all us.
It made 1,320 foot-pounds of force.
Yeah. And, yeah, you can still pull it too, so probably still,
or you can pull it.
It's just because it's taking so much power,
yeah.
You have to put it out.
Like,
put a quarter watt pull out.
So short.
It might not even be, it may not live long enough to make it to the first one. So that's 27 pounds.
Gosh, I wonder what the laser can make is all those things.
32.
Your phone's still good.
Mullet Power.
didn't even know this thing went that high.
Oh, brother!
What is the max on this dyno? I don't even know.
That was it.
Next pull, it's just gonna say error.
Yeah. It looks like it still was hooking. So are we done, Steve? Are we good?
I'm done. I'm. If you're happy, I'm happy. The rest of it we do at the track. Yeah.
That was. I didn't want to say anything until it's fully over. That was an insanely smooth dyno.
Yeah.
Like, how did they go that smooth?
What?
No, it's never gone that smooth.
Filled in and finishing the wiring on the windows, and then put the big tires on it, hook the trailer up to it, and send it off to the Midwest track. So.
All right, let's go over here and take a look at the numbers.
Coming up to this car, lined up there.
Here are pulls. Let me get this one. Yep. 2019, 1940, 1830, 1609, 1285. So just progression, you know, working on the tune-up, adding some boost, working on the tune-up, adding boost, working on tune-up, adding boost, working on tune-up, adding boost. Still super safe. I'll take a look at it. We'll probably do a plug read on it too. We've already done one plug read on it. Always remember, plugs supersede everything. Doesn't matter what your numbers say, the plug is what matters. And it's short on timing, so we've got super safe. It's probably about 4 degrees short on timing right now at that bar level.
I'm gonna throw about six at it when we leave. I'll go up to like 6-7 more degrees. Once it kicks the head gasket out, I'll back it down one.
Back it down one, yeah.
No, I'll call you.
Yeah, I need to fix this. So, pretty sweet deal. I think we're right spot on money. This is going to be really nice. So, super safe tune-up right there. More left in it. Definitely more boost left in it. Probably another 500 at the wheel. And then when you have them strapped down as tight as we got it strapped down, there's a lot of power loss in the tire, but that's why everybody goes to the hub dynos now, including myself, which has a hub dyno. Much less power loss from the tire. So anyways, I am Steve Morris. That is Cletus McFarland. This is Mullet Repowered, ready to rock. Peace out. How long?
2 week swap.
Yo, that's right. 2 weeks for the guys to do everything here. So probably one more day in the downpipes to actually put them where they're gonna be. Pretty impressive. So from from LS to big block, that's a pretty good time frame. So I'm Steve Morris, have a great day.